Mr. Vivekanand Sagar is Bachelor of Law from SGR College of Law in 2010, Masters in Law in Business Law from Kuvempu University, Postgraduate Diploma in HRM, Kuvempu University. So I was going through your academic things and I was thinking like you have a series of academic credits, MA in Sociology. He secured first rank in Masters of Law and is pursuing PhD on enforcement of copyright issue in film and recording industries. Presently, he is an independently practicing advocate in the field of intellectual property rights and civil litigation. Guest faculty at Ramaya College of Law, international consultant in Kunming International Center for Arbitration and Mediation, consultant in Karnataka State Council of Science Technology, ISC, and has been an honorary designated as Research Associate, Center for Intellectual Property Rights, Research and Advocacy, CIPRA, and Ministry of Industry and Commerce, Government of India at National Law School of India University, Bangalore. This is since 2012 to 18. Apart from this, Vivekanand Sagar also has credentials of papers and articles which have been published in books and journals. He has been invited as resource person for various institutions and organizations where he delivers guest lectures on subject intellectual property rights by Ministry of Micro and Small and Medium Enterprises, that's MSME. So with this introduction, we open the forum for you, sir.
A very good morning to one and all present in this particular program. I was just going through the entire program schedule, the way the schedule is being framed, having a close sync with the present situation and scenario, as well as posing lot of questions for the Internet of Things or the technology which is having interface with every day in and out of a person's, it may be a business relationship, it may be a personal data, it may be reminders, it may be for his pleasure, for his happiness, for the family, for the friend, for the business. Everywhere there is technology. Everywhere it has been connected. And technology, of course, has both, is also a boon, at the same time it's also a bane. Both it has advantage, it has a disadvantage. So in all these things, we are going to discuss about how this technology emerged or came up through or becoming as an innovation, and being a technology as an innovation, and how you are protecting those innovation, under which umbrella you are protecting the innovations for those technologies, and how are you going to manage those technology under the intellectual property umbrella is what we are going to speak today. Now, let me put up my slide for better understanding and having more clarity on the subject matter. Yeah. Let me go on a full screen mode. Yes. Yeah, may I know that, is it on the full screen, madam?
Yeah, it's good, sir. Please go ahead.
Yeah, I also request the host to tell me what's coming in my chat box, because will I be able to see the chat box? Then I have to leave my PPT, right?
We will be moderating you. It's been like this that every 30 minutes I'll remind you, and I will make a note of questions in the chat box, comments. I will be monitoring and I will moderate it at the end of 30 minutes periodically, sir.
Agreed. But a small little change I request the organizer, sir, that my session will not be like I keep on telling and they will ask me a question. Rather, I ask question to the participants and they need to keep on be answering.
I think you can open the forum to be interactive because few speakers also wish that. And I think with one small reminder and instruction that we will be unmuting all the participants. So please be responsible. Right now I can hear somebody talking. So please don't disturb the session. You have to be very conscious. Whoever is talking, tech team, please monitor. So whoever is, I think this is one glitch in Microsoft Teams. If I'm muting everybody, everybody goes on muting. We have taken so many inputs from this 4-day session that we will flood them with one huge mail. What are the things they need to look into?
Wonderful. No, that is where the technological upgradation and technology management plays a role. Identify a problem and you fix a problem, and that's where the innovation comes up. So with starting with that, I would also what I request the participants is you can mute all, okay, and let the participants put in their comments or their answers in the chat box for the questions which I pose. Okay, so a small rule for all my participants is that kindly keep your hands on the keyboard. The questions comes from my side. You need to answer it in the chat box. You need not open up your mic. Kindly answer only your answer in the chat box. And I request the host to read out the answers provided by there. Okay, that's all. It's a very simple, and the answers need not be a lengthy one. It's a shorter one. Okay. So let me start. I was telling you that what is this technology management, and the whole scheme of my presentation will be on innovation part, identifying a problem and coming out with an innovation, protecting those innovation through IPR umbrella is a third phase, and what are the rights and what is eligibility criteria for filing a patent or a trademark or a design or any other IPR, okay? And how do we manage all these things? So that is what we are going to discuss today. Okay, now my question starts from the first slide. What do you see in my slide? Simple question, simple answers I require. Everyone needs to be actively responding in the chat box. What do you see in my slide? Yes. Answers to be read by host.
Yes, sir. I am monitoring that.
Yep, madam.
So there are answers which is saying wicket, three stamps, stumps. Okay.
What I request, one more thing is, kindly do not repeat the answers which is already told by other participants. So that is one caveat. Okay. Yes, go ahead, madam.
That reduces our task. Cricket wickets, ground.
Okay. What else? Quickly.
It's all same, sir. Everybody is writing wickets. Now it's pitch, target, wooden cricket stumps.
Very good.
Lines.
Very good.
So I'm not reading the repetitive answers. Target.
Good.
Three pillars, lines.
Okay.
A picture taken of ground at noon side, the shadow.
Mm-hmm.
With stumps.
Mm-hmm.
Wickets already to be bound.
Mm-hmm.
Shadow of wicket, colors.
Mm-hmm.
Green grass.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful observation.
Grass, shadows. White line, stumps. Wickets to be bowled. Yeah, that was already there.
Wonderful.
Lining is okay.
More than enough. I really appreciate you all people answering so quickly on these points. But my question is, do you find these kind of wickets in the cricket now? Yes or no? Question. Yeah.
No,
you don't find these kind of wickets. Why? Can you identify the problem? Or why don't you find these kind of wickets? What was the problem in these wickets?
In the chat box.
Answers in the chat box only, yeah? Please.
Yeah, we are looking at the chat box simultaneously, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
What might be the reason? They're just saying no. Bales not going off, color may be a problem.
Okay, fine. Next.
Closer examination when there is a wicket gone.
The
New widgets are tech savvy with camera, outdated, obsolete, smart one now. Difference of opinion may be heavy.
LED enabled stumps we are using now.
No microphone. Yes, sir.
Please don't switch on your mic. Only put your answers in the chat box. Okay. Yes. So you don't find this, and now you find LED.
Why? Sir, one more thing, sir. Vivek, sir, like there are a few participants who are unable to use chat box in their apps on phone. So if it is somebody who wants to speak, one or two, I think we can make provisions, sir, with your permission.
It's okay with me, not an issue, but it may take a lot of time of my presentation. That's why I just wanted to avoid voice response. Okay. Just go with the chat response. If you would like to say, even if one or two, we can still allow, not an issue. Yeah, it's all your session, it's not my session.
Applied usage of LED, less ambiguity, old one was without camera.
Wait. I'll pick a few answers who have said rightly that. I said the question was, what is the problem you find in this? So if you said that there is a ambiguity in what? In decision making. Okay, that's the first problem. So that is a problem which was identified. Of course, many said color, it's durability, it may break, etc. and etc. Many people said, but the question was on what is a problem you find in this particular wickets. Consider today there is a cricket match between India and Australia. Okay. Dhoni is there. In the cricket match, it is a last ball, last run. One run is required for the World Cup. Dhoni is in the crease. At the other side, from Australian side, the bowler bowls the ball. It comes near the bat, goes near the wicket. Is there a out or not out? Can anyone say it's a last ball which is required? It's a last ball, only one run required for the World Cup to be won by India, and the bowler bowls the ball, it goes near the bat and it goes near the wickets. Is there a out or not out?
Somebody from cricket should answer this. Sir, I am very poor at cricket. I will only be moderator, sir, though I wanted to answer.
Anybody can answer, yes.
Out, no. I'm reading answers for you, sir.
Yes, madam. So some say it's an out. Some say it's not out. Okay, anyone else?
Second chat box and read the answers quickly.
Yes. Madam, in the due course, those answers which is more relevant to me, which I quote, kindly tell their names for me. Okay. For example, Sandhya said no, or likewise. Yeah. Any responses, madam, coming in? Are the responses coming in? Okay, of course, many would have said yes, it's an out.
The response is too much, so I am unable to catch their names. The window is scrolling up.
Don't worry. The answers are obvious for me. Either some of them would have supported for yes, and some of them would have said no, it is not out, right?
No, so this is an interesting answer, sir, like it might be wide or no ball, sir, from Shrikant and Pradeep.
No, good ball.
Okay.
Next.
So there is Shaikh Basha who is saying it may be no ball and maybe four or Sheta Tripathi. Then not out.
But yes, going.
Sucheta Guru.
Yes, going.
Yeah, that's it.
Yes,
sir.
Okay. That's good. See, here's the situation for all of us. The situation is what? We had our. The situation is what? The situation is that there is a World Cup match in which lakhs together of people are watching this. Worldwide people are watching this particular match. And a small decision, whether it is out or not out, depending on this, if it is a manual or a umpire. Now, the same, now Dhoni sees, now the ball has went, Dhoni sees the umpire. So now many of them had an ambiguity that, okay, whether it is out or not out. So now what do you do? Now you go and approach, you ask the third umpire or the umpire. First you go to the umpire. Now the umpire sees whether it is out or not. So now he also gets perplexed. He's also in the same situation of yours, where he is not able to decide whether it is out or not out. So what is the next step? The next step is it will be referred for the third umpire. What does the third umpire do? You must have seen in a situation where, in the earlier circumstance, where the ball used to come near, whether first point is whether the ball touched the bat, that has to be checked. And after that, whether the ball touched the wickets. So these are the 2 points to be observed. Now, ball passes through this. So he has, what you say earlier, you can also be seeing that there's a kind of a radar or a BP kind of thing, which waves, okay, where they are going to recognize whether the ball touched the bat or not. So the bat, it has touched the bat, and now whether it has come and touched the wicket or not, that's also now the we see that it goes back and forth video. Like these, all the things which we used to see. So that means we still had a problem of decision making, okay? And ultimately, now even third umpire, after seeing back and forth, he gives out. Now tell me, my dear participants, many of them would have been seeing this, and there will be thousands of people disappointed out of it. And many a times people who have said that, hey, come on, that was not out. Even then we have lost the match. However, it'll keep on going. But my question is, my dear friends, that here was a professor. What did he do? The simple innovation and a simple theory he brought out, or the simple formula which we read in the high school. What was that? What is that simple theory or the high school science which we learned? Can anyone give an example? What is that I'm referring to?
So there is also comments Dhoni finishes match. I mean, it's creating a lot of interest because it is cricket. I think I am the only person who don't understand cricket here. But there are also points like Sachin is curious to know like how this is related to IPR, and Kalyani ma'am is saying re-examine the play for closer examination. Sucheta ma'am is saying law of Newton, radioactivity. I mean, what not answers you're getting, sir?
Okay. No, I mean, I'm interested to see a specific answer, which is that which is faster than something.
I guess mind.
No.
Sir, light. Sound.
Exactly. That's a point which I'm referring to. A small theory or small principle of what is that which passes through or than the sound, that is the light which passes through faster than the sound. So what did this particular professor, okay, a small inventor who saw the cricket for many years from Australia, he was from Australia, Mr. Inventor from Broughton. What did he do? He saw this particular cricket match and a problem with respect to decision making, accuracy in decision making. This was a problem which he identified. And what did this professor do? He came out with this particular technology, the simple basic principle of science which we learned in our high school. What is this contains? This contains a sensor, a light, a LED bulbs, okay? And a battery, and a battery sends a signal that there is some kind of an object which came and touched on me, hence the light glows. So this particular simple technology which he developed, this technology and the testing for light up stumps has been in development for almost 3 years, okay? And ultimately he came up with this, and he filed, and the specialty of this particular stumps was that the stumps are touch sensitive and blink whenever at the bails are taken off. The sensor in the bail can detect within one of thousands of second. So that is the technology which he developed. Earlier, one of my participants was asking, sir, how is this wicket is relevant to our, IPR? This is a relevant, sir. Just wait, I have not even completed. This is a prelude. What I'm telling is, sir, this particular professor developed what? A small sensor, a LED bulb, and indication with a, what you say, a battery based one. So this is what, and which gives a decision as fast as possible. So with this, he filed a patent. Now, what do you mean by patent? Why do you require a patent on a technology? And how do you manage this technology was a point. Now, is this, okay, now he developed this sensor, LED bulbs and other things. Is this an innovation? The next question is this an innovation? Yes or no?
Yes, they're answering yes, sir.
Okay, it is an innovation. Okay, now if it is an innovation, a patent requires three major criteria. One, it should be new. It should be non-obvious. Third, it should be industrially applicable. That means you should be able to reproduce many a times. Okay, first, is this technology new? Or how do you say it is new? New is something which is not already existing in the yesterday. Anything which is not existing yesterday and today, if you have come out with, then that becomes new. Okay, so if it is new, can you agree that this is new? Yes, you agree that it is new. Second, is it non-obvious? What do you mean by non-obvious? A non-obvious requirement of a patent is something which is obvious for a person who is skilled in the art. For example, if a mechanical engineer or a motor engineer, today we find a car which runs with per liter of petrol to the extent of 15 to 20 liters, 15 to 20 kilometer per liter of petrol. Now, a particular engineer comes up with a new innovation or new improvement over the already existing knowledge that he makes 25 kilometer of mileage per liter of petrol. Is it obvious or non-obvious? Can anyone respond in the chat answers who is an engineer or having engineering background? A mileage of 20 to 22, 23, 25 kilometer. Is it obvious?
Obvious. First answer by Srinivasan.
Okay. Srinivas says it is obvious. Wonderful. Wonderful. Now, can you tell me at the same time, Mr. Srinivas comes out with a new engine, which gives 40 kilometer of mileage. Is it obvious or non-obvious?
People say it's obvious. Shruti is saying obvious. Shruti, Harita, Atul.
40 kilometers, madam. 40 kilometers per liter of petrol for a car engine. Is it obvious or non-obvious?
Well, that is non-obvious. Non-obvious.
Excellent. Exactly. See, obviousness test is a subjective in a patent office. Now consider here in this particular technology which you have developed, that particular Australian inventor for LED bulbs. LED bulbs are already known. Sensors are already known. But the technology which is embedded in this particular sensor, which gives a result with 1/1000 seconds, which earlier it did not give. Hence, it is non-obvious. Hence, an engineer who comes up with a 40 kilometer of mileage for per liter of petrol becomes a non-obvious. Hence, he qualifies the second test of non-obviousness. And third is industrial applicability, that where you will be able to replicate that same engine or the sensors or light. Hence, it is patentable. Now, once when you have a patent. Sir, yenna sir, adu sound vandrathu.
So thank you, sir.
Okay. So the point of reference is, my dear friend, consider you are all the inventors, okay, or you have developed this particular technology. What would you do? Consider you have not filed patent today at your laboratory, today at your house, today at your factory or your place of laboratory. You have developed this particular technology. What are you going to do? Yes. Answers, please. Whether it is an engine you have come out with. Sorry?
Close, guard that. Keep it as a secret and closely guard. Do not want it to be copied by others.
Okay. You wanted to keep it secretly, right?
Yes.
Why do you want to keep it secretly? Won't you want to get money?
No. It is my invention. So I would want...
If it is your invention, what would you like to do? Okay, you wanted to keep it secret. Okay, done. What about others? What about others? Any other chat?
Get it patented.
Some of them said they wanted to patent it. Okay, wonderful. Next.
Pradeep Singh says, try to keep it explored by many but generate money. Atul says, from use free. Mohit says, get it patented. I'm sorry, I'm addressing all your by names, professors, so I have to be really quick, so kindly excuse me. Rajesh says, working for money, obviously. Srinivasan says, I will keep the secret until application grant. Sindhu says, protect.
One second, wait. The person who said, I will keep it secret until the application is granted. Can you name? Can you know the name of a person?
Srinivasan KP.
Sir, if you wait, actually in a patent, if you wait till the application is being granted, it takes 2 years, 3 years. Okay, you cannot wait. You should not wait. Today you file application for patent. Tomorrow you talk to the industry. Tomorrow you go and talk to the industry or any person, commercialize it tomorrow only. You need not wait till the grant. Please kindly bear in your mind.
Can I ask?
So that is where, please. You need to be very careful. You need not wait till the grant. As many of them supported that, sir, I will go and file a patent. Why do you want to file a patent? Because a patent is a document. A patent is a grant given by the state, stating that Mr. Vivekanand Sagar or Srinivas has filed an application and they are the inventor of this particular technology, and he elicited that what is this technology, and I define what is my I claim what is my invention. And the patent gives you, as a few of them said, that sir, I will keep it secret. Madam, you need not keep it secret, because you have an apprehension that someone will copy you, right? That apprehension will be sorted out by getting a patent or filing for a patent, right? So that means today you file for a patent and tomorrow you go and talk to the industry, neither the industry or anyone else, or when the product comes into the market, whenever someone sees, hey, this is a wonderful product, why can't I make? What does this involve? It involves a sensor, a bale, LED bulbs, that's all, right? Come on, let me fix it. Okay, what is the cost? Okay, now let me talk about this. What is the cost of this particular product? Can anyone say what is the cost of this particular product? I hope people are able to catch me, right? Madam, am I clear?
Yeah, they are right. Typing. I'm just waiting, sir.
Maybe less than 100 or 200, couple of bucks, that's all.
Wonderful. Okay, anyone else? What is the cost of this?
Says 5K, Srinivasan says $50.
Oh my goodness. Then?
And Rajesh sir says 2000.
Then?
Yeah, nothing, sir. I'm just waiting. That's for the
more than enough. More than enough. Some say 1,500, 100 to 200, right? And some say $50. Any other response?
$10. $10. Bhargava, Sucheta, 1,500.
Wonderful. Enough. That's more than enough. That is where if you are thinking the product cost. Now tell me, my dear participants, those who said these answers. If you are the inventor of the product, can you tell me what is the price you are going to give this technology? If you are the inventor of this particular product, please, what I request the participants is kindly put your answers in the chat box. Do not open your mic. Okay, I have requested the host to answer. They are going to answer. Otherwise, there is a lot of what you say. I will not be able to catch up their
pace. Surabhi says, may earn in $1 million. Mohit says, depending on audience whom you are focusing.
Mm-hmm.
Rora sir says, depends on stage of patenting. Rajesh says, 50,000. Kalyani says, couple of lakhs. Or in lakhs. Okay, that is Rajesh again. Pradeep Singh says, 5K, strict with same. Sucheta Tripathi, depends on the market.
Wonderful. All this is technology management, and that is what we are talking about today. Okay, how do you use some said, sir, it depends upon the market, sir, it depends upon what you say, demand, it depends upon the customer, it depends upon the person who takes, it depends upon so many things. I say it depends upon when there is a world match, I said Dhoni is playing. It's a one ball required. One run required. Last ball to go. The ball has gone. Whether it is out or not out. Now tell me, what is your cost of your technology? What is the cost of your technology? Whether it runs in thousands, whether it runs in lakhs.
The answer is millions.
It runs in millions. See, it runs in millions. A small technology runs in millions. Is it possible? I'll just demonstrate to you. Can anyone tell me? In one of the cricket match, when one of our today, there is a rule that earlier you could have seen that after the cricket match, after the victory, people used to pull that wickets and roam around the stadium that they used to do. Can they do today? They cannot do because there is a rule. Why? In one of the match where a person who comes and picks up this particular wicket and the umpire says, please don't pick up, it costs dash. If anyone who is a cricket lover who has been very closely observing this particular thing, can anyone say what was the cost he told for the match? Anyone? In your chat, answers only.
$3,000. No answers, sir. There are no answers. I'm just
$3,000.
Okay.
No
sir,
answers,
sir. Yes, no problem. The point of reference is, this inventor did not give his technology for sale. Rather, he said, I am the inventor. I will manufacture the wickets. I will supply it to whoever required, whether it is BCCI or whoever IPL, who is organizer or the host of the IPL or BPL or whatever it is. And he said, I'm not selling this wickets to you. Rather, license my wickets to you. What do you mean by licensing? He said, see, if a match is happening in Bangalore Chinnaswamy Stadium, I will give 4 set of wickets for this particular match. You shall use it in that match only. You cannot use when you go and play in Kolkata or Chennai. The wickets should be used only in that particular place, only for that particular match on so and so date, and it has to be returned back. If this is a condition, can I know what is the cost of license he charged for it? Can anyone imagine what is the licensing cost which he brought out with? Anyone? Any answers?
Most
it's not sale.
Recognition lives forever in comparison of money. So Ravi Saxena says, if cricket fan, then for free.
No. We are all talking of technology management. We are not talking about charity. Okay.
Ravin Kumar sir, says 30 lakhs.
Absolutely. Lakhs. Absolutely.
Crore.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
License cost.
Yes.
Atul says
license. Yes, madam. Yes, that's enough. So yeah. He charged 30 lakh rupees for 4 set of wicket to be used only in that particular match, and 30 lakh is nothing for the match to give an accurate decision. Right? They don't mind it. So this was because of what? This was because of the intellectual property. This was because of the development of technological inventions, and that has resulted in protection through IPR. That is where the IPR plays a very important role. If you did not have the protection of a patent, if you did not have a protection under the intellectual property, if you did not have come out with this, if you have come out with this invention and sold it in the market and give it to the market, everyone would have been replicated it, right? And what is the reward for the invention? What is the reward for your intellectual output? What is the reward for your efforts? And that is being granted by IPR. And that is where IPR becomes very important in technological management. And that is an importance which I wanted to throw at the initial stage by giving this particular example. A small technology today is more than enough to earn millions of dollars. And the question of the technology transfer from one person to another person. And I said, the person is from Australia. He did not, and IPR is territorial in its nature. That means if you file a patent application, a patent being granted in India or in Australia, only then it is protected in Australia. If you want to get protected in India, he has to file an application in India. Likewise, that is once again a management of IP where you find your product has where are the countries or which are the countries you have a market for your product. For example, as I said, car engine. If you have come out with a car engine which gives 40 kilometer per liter of petrol, won't you find there is a huge demand in various countries? And now coming to the cricket, is it fine for you to file a application in China for cricket, for this particular stumps in the cricket match, to file an application in China? Is it good to go in China, file an application in China for a patent? Yes or no? Answers.
So there are no answers yet.
Okay. The question is, you are from Australia, you have filed application in India because you found there is a good market. Now, would you like to file an application in China for the same technology to get a protection? Yes or no? No answers yet?
Yes, we need to file it in China.
Yes and no, sir.
Okay, there are both yes and no's. Dear sir, you need not file application in China because they are not interested in cricket. They don't know about cricket. And once there is no market and once there is no people to use these wickets and they are not interested in cricket, what is the point in getting protection over there? So that is where IP management, by looking at which are the country where there is a demand, where the people will copy your technology, there you need to file application for protection. And that is where you require a knowledge about how IP will be managed, how your technology will be managed in the respective country for the respective protection. Okay. Yes, in the same context, he has filed application in India. You can all check the application number AU2010. He has filed in the year 2010. 306420B2 is a application number in India. You can find this. And what is the title of the invention he has given? He did not say wicket technology. He did not say decision making technology. He did not say about the technology at all. What did he say? He said it is a system for indicating movement of an article from one position or orientation to another position or orientation. Did he anywhere tell about the wicket? No. This is how he has defined his title of the invention. And that is where the patent plays a very important role. Okay, this is an Indian application which he has filed in India. Okay, so in all these circumstances of technological relevancy, in what all way you will be able to see if there is a functionality such as the technology or the process of the car engine to give a higher mileage. So if there is a functional feature, then you get it protected under patents. And some of them said that, sir, I would also like to keep it as a trade secret. For example, your Coca-Cola or a Pepsi, the formula, they have kept it secret. And there is a thin line of differentiation between when do you want to keep your technology secret and when do you want to keep file your patent? Because if you file your patent, that means you are disclosing to the whole world that I am the inventor. I have invented this particular technology and anyone can be able to do it. Within their but they cannot use because it has been protected for 20 years. And after 20 years, it comes into public domain and anyone can use. Okay, so that is where you find and in the Coca-Cola and the Pepsi formula, they kept it as trade secrets because they know that the formulation which is used for Coca-Cola, no one ever able to break it. Hence, they kept it as trade secrets because the one point you need to consider or decision making is that if you file a patent after 20 years, it comes into public domain. If you keep it as trade secrets, you can keep on using. Right? You know, from 1800s, they are the Coca-Cola is there. Okay, more than 150 years of its history. So that is where you go for functionality under the patents or trade secrets. You go for expression of your thoughts. Like your storybooks, J.K. Rowling's Harry Potter. Sir, one lady sat at a place, thought of a story. She wrote a book, gave it to the publisher. Five publishers throwed her banned book and said, who the hell will read your book? But today you consider, because of the effect of the copyright, her book is being translated into 101 languages. Her book is being copied into various number of thousands of copies sold across the world. Her book is being transformed into movies. Her book's character has been having a lot of personality right and copyright protection for it. And today she earns in millions of dollars just by sitting around, say, with just one story. And all that which I'm asking you people is a one story such as J.K. Rowling's Harry Potter and one patent such as the cricket technology. Right? And you put a brand name for it, that becomes a trademark. Okay, so this is what innovation or the relationship between the creativity, invention and innovation. Let me skip and let me tell you about this innovation radar. So for an IPR, you did not require any physical assets. They require a platform. You need to identify a problem. You come out with a solution. Identify your consumers. Understand the consumer experience. Process it. Have a supply chain. Build a network and come out with a brand. And what did this make? There was a problem of supply chain of a goods from a manufacturer to the consumer. Amazon came in and said, I will quickly deliver. I'll give you the list of people who are ready to sell for A price, B price, C price, and whoever you want, you can choose. The market was ready with your hand. The market is ready in your, laptop. Racket is ready in your mobile phone. And this is a technology which they came up with, for which that one click patent, they had a patent on one click of Amazon's, and they have a patent over the technology. Paytm, today you need not go to a bank, whether it is a Google Pay or whether it is Paytm or it is phone pay, you need not go out to the bank and withdraw, give an application and you sign one check and give it to the bank and he verifies and say, sir, your signature is not tallying. Can you sign once again? These were the problems they identified and said, okay, the problem was solved by the technology. ID, you know, what is a famous thing of ID? Can anyone say what is a famous thing of ID? ID, a Bangalore-based a company. What is the problem which he identified and what is the solution he came out with? Only two questions I'm asking. What is the problem which he identified and what is the solution he came up with? Answers, yes, please.
The answers are like hotel, batter, Srinivasan says hotel, Kalyani Suresh says batter.
Very good.
Yeah.
One more point. I'm looking for one more specific problem which he identified and a solution which he came out with.
There are only two replies waiting.
Any other response? No problem. That's more than enough.
Pradeep Singh sir says morning breakfast.
Very good. Excellent. Exactly. Sir, to make a idli.
Makaranda Ramesh says meduvada. Mohit can't get the question.
Exactly. Okay. Enough. Exactly. Yeah. Sir.
Actually, Mohit Tiwari sir can't get the question. He's saying he
no problem. Don't worry. Follow the subject here afterwards. You'll get it. The point of reference is, sir, the ID regularly in our house in the morning or to make a vada or an idli, it's a long process where one day early, you need to soak the rice in the water. After soaking night, you need to grind it nicely. Then you need to keep it for some kind of fermentation till morning, and then you need to use the batter for idli making or vada. Once again, vada making is an art. Why? Because you need to have a vada with 360 degree round radius with a hole in the center with crispy and crunchy. Only then it will be tasty. And otherwise, you will have Australia, Africa, all designs of vadas. So we don't want that. If you want a 360 degree exact vada, and especially in the morning time for women's who cooks in the morning, it takes a lot of their time, especially for the working professional women's. It will be very difficult for them to make and involve in all these activity. So he identified a problem and he brought out with a solution to save the time of the women's. And what he did that he came out with a vada making a small pouch. This pouch is patented. He has a patent over that particular pouch. That means, what did this pouch made? It has a batter in it. You just need to push the batter. After pushing the batter, you need to just press that particular knob which is there in the top, and you will get exact 360 degree radius with crispy, crunchy, and a center in a hole in the center of a vada. This is what he came up with, and this is a patented one. He has a patent over it. So anyone wants to use it, they have to take a permission and royalty out of it. And this is what he came up with. And this simple technology did not have science, did not have great rocket science is required for this. Rather, a simple observation, an innovative mind to bring a solution is what all you require. And you have a market and you will be managing your technology. Uber, sir, Uber and Ola, they don't own a single car in the world. They don't own a single car, but today they are the largest transporters. Right? This is possible, and the technologies which they came up with were protected through IPRs, through brand names, trademark, copyright, patents, and etc. And hence, IPR plays a role in technology management. You know about the Netflix, Zomato, once again, they don't own a single restaurant, but they are the largest supplier of foods to the people or consumers or the foodies. Okay, now L'Oreal, other examples. Let me not take up this as of now because I just wanted to quickly run through the other important. Yeah, this is a patent which I was telling about, and the inventor was Abdul Nasir, who stays near Mahadevpura, Whitefield, near Whitefield. So he has a company over there, and he has this particular patent over that particular vada making invention. Okay, and even see, as I said, you every day can vada. So that's where, or the idli batter, or the coffee, filter coffee experience with exactly the shape. So the shape of, or the packaging of a bottle is also protected under industrial designs. Okay, where he was a startup. Okay, 100% natural products. So these are all the things which he think of, and he patented the packaging technologies as well. So, okay. After all these things, let me skip this particular point and take you people through the major portion, because want of time, I just to want to go ahead. I did not get any reminder from the host about 30 minutes or 40 minutes. So nevertheless, how many more minutes do I have?
Yes, sir, you have another 40 minutes. Please receive that 20 minutes for QA, sir.
Okay. Done. Yeah. So with all these understanding of how technology plays a very important role and why you need to be protecting those through an IPR, and what are the issues which you encounter when someone else copies your invention, when the artistic work, when the literary work, you write an article, a research article, and someone copies your research article, and how do you protect it from copying? So these are the things which we are going to discuss hereafter, the various tools of IPR and some in the issues, how various issues were being encountered and being solved by Indian IP system. Those things I'll be discussing about. So what is basically an IP? Now I'm coming to the topic of understanding an IP. So far we discussed about how innovation, how technology, a small upgradation in the technology can have a play a very good commercial role, and how to have that commercial returns, you need to file an IPR protection for it, and then jump into the market, and you will be able to protect your innovations without any physical assets, without any big rocket science. You will be able to, you will be able to earn a huge amount of commercial returns through royalty, compensation, profits, or licensing, etc. And that is the reason of IPR. So what is an IPR? IPR is a property which is created with intellect, such as an invention for books, painting, song, symbol, name, image, designs used in the business. It's a legal right. Okay, a small idea is more than enough to get it huge commercial returns. It's a legal right conferred, and such properties are called as IPR. IPR are territorial in its nature. Because you have a patent in India, that does not mean that your patent is protected in other countries. If at all, if you want to get in other country protection, you need to file an application in the respective country. And that does not mean that, okay, sir, should I file application in Australia? That means, should I go there? No. You need to enter into national phase in India, file an application in India. Through WIPO route, you have 150 plus countries who is joined through PCT route, that is called as Patent Cooperation Treaty. Sitting in India, you can file an application in 150 country, whichever country you feel that you have your product has a relevance. Now you come out with a mask, a natural biodegradable mask. You come out with a ventilator, a cheap, low cost ventilator, or you come out with the coronavirus drug. What about it? Right? So that is where you need to be very careful and protect your IPR effectively so that no one else copies your invention or do a piracy of your invention. So these are the various types of IPR, such as patents, trademark, copyright, designs, geographical indication, trade secrets, semiconductor and integrated circuits, layout designs, plant varieties. So GI, once again, a very important heritage. It's also called as a sleeping beauty of India, where geographical indication has been granted for a natural, agricultural or a manufactured good. Okay, such as your Channapatna toys, your agricultural goods such as Kalburgi Tur Dal, okay, your Tirupati Laddu, your Mysore Silk Sari, Nagpur Orange, Darjeeling Tea. Today Darjeeling Tea is being sold worldwide. It has a great demand. Okay, so these are the geographical indication protection being granted, and copyrights, especially for faculties, academic institutions. Copyright plays a very important role for the research, the literary works which they come out with. So copyright is an exclusive right granted for the creator of an expression of an idea. So if you have expressed some kind of an idea of a subject matter, then you get a copyright protection. Copyright owner has a right to reproduce, translate, adapt, perform, distribute, and publicly display your work. The one beauty of copyright is that you need not register your copyright, and that is no mandatory for it. Okay, as soon as the work comes into picture, you get protection. Then registration is not mandatory, and it is it is recommended that have a registration so that you have a certificate in your hand, which is a conclusive proof that, hey, I'm the owner of this particular thing and this is where I'm giving. And if someone infringes, you'll be able to stop him from infringing your copyright. And it has a clear evidentially proof before the court. So literary works, what are the various works which is covered under copyright? You have literary works such as your books, essay, compilation, computer program and technology. There is a small thin line of gap. A mere computer program is protected under copyright, and a computer program having a novel hardware, which is a technology, has a protection under the patent. You need to clearly bifurcate this and have an effective protection, because copyright, you make a slight change, you will not be able to stop others from using. But in patent, if you work around my invention, if you have copied the technology, that it may not be as it is, but it is having a substantial you have taken, then it is an infringement. So your data sheets, your research, during your research, you come out with various data sheets, right? Or forget about the data sheets of a research result. Your cricket match data sheet, what is the scoring? There is a very important case of Star Sports versus various telecom company. When earlier you must have seen that there used to be a charge of 30 rupees for cricket match alert. If you want to get an alert by a telecom company, they said I will charge 30 rupees as soon as there is an out, there is a no ball, there is a century or ball to ball scoring will be sent over message to you. Okay, this was a technology which they came up with the telecom company and they charged 30 rupees. Now, who owned the rights of broadcasting in a cricket match? Can anyone say who owned the data, the broadcasting rights of the cricket, the data and everything, and who owns it? Any answers, please?
Yeah, I'm just checking the chat box now.
No problem, madam.
BCCI.
Excellent. So BCCI owns the right over telecasting. Now, what does BCCI do? They transfer the rights or they auction the rights to the various television channels, okay, like sports channels, etc. Whoever wants to purchase, they will purchase it. How does the television channels get revenue? And for close together of money, they bid and they take it. So now, how does television channels get revenue? Answers, please.
Yeah, I'm looking at the chat box, sir. No answers yet.
No problem. Let them answer, ma'am.
Advertising?
Correct. So they get the revenue through an advertisement. Now the sports channel, the Star Sports files a case against a 2-3 telecom company and say, hey, come on. Now I own the entire rights of the broadcasting, of the movie, of the cricket match with the datas. Now if a telecom company charges 30 rupees for when there is an out, when there is a no ball, when there is a century, if a message goes to the consumer, will he be interested in viewing your match over the television? He will not be interested in viewing the match in the television. If he does not view the match in the television, there is a loss to the telecom company because it all depends upon the, what do you say that? It all depends on what? In the television, what is the major yardstick? What is the yardstick in television?
No answer, sir. Like bark, I think, a TRP.
Yeah, exactly. It is your TRP. That means how many lakhs together of people or thousands of people are viewing your television or that particular serial or that particular channel plays an important role. So if people does not view your cricket match which you are putting live telecast, and how will the telecom company get, or how will the Star Sports will get revenue? They will not get revenue. So they filed a suit against this telecom company, and the telecom company sir said that, hey, come on, what did we do, sir? There was a match which is happening, there was an out. I sent a message to my consumer that there is an out. It is a fact. What is that creative in the copyright? There is a match which happened and I'm telling that there is an out. It is a fact. I'm reporting a fact situation. Hence, they should not own a copyright over it. So this was our argument, and more fully, sir, it is a national interest. You cannot expect everyone to open up their television and see that particular cricket match, because they are busy with their other business. And cricket match is a national event. Lakhs together of people would like to know. And if you curb this, this stops the dissemination of information. And you have all right to information, where your Right to Information Act 2005 will come into picture and say, hey, come on, you are restricting me from circulating the information. And I'm telling about a fact. It is not a movie which I'm telecasting. And some of the television you must have also seen where one side there was a news which was running and the bottom you would have seen the another screen about the cricket match live telecasted. So the court said, of course, and of course there was an exception under the Doordarshan Act, where whenever a cricket match happened, which is a cricket match or a hockey or any other national games where people, large people wanted to see, you cannot expect everyone to see. Hence, it has to be telecasted in Doordarshan on a free of basis. Like any magazine you come out with, one copy you should send it to the public library on a free of charge. Likewise, that this was a class and they said, this is what we are doing. And the court examined the situation and said, hey, come on, of course, if you are not just giving this particular ball to ball information to the consumer on a free basis, you are charging for it. Are you entitled for the charge? If people does not view the television, then why should the sports company or sports television channel pay BCCI huge amount of money and purchase the rights of broadcasting? So to create a balance and justifiability, they said, okay, if at all, if you want to telecast in such manner, take a permission from Star Sports because they own a copyright over that particular data. Okay, so that is where the ruling came and the test of hot news doctrine. The court said that the hot news, you are telling, you are selling your product as a hot news for the consumer and you are making money out of it. They said, no, hot news doctrine supplies and you cannot make money out of it. If at all, if you want to take, do it, take a license from him. That was the case. But at a later stage, the court also said, okay, if at all, if you want to telecast it as a factual situation, report it after a delay of certain time. That is 20 seconds, 40 seconds, 1 minute, 2 minutes, 5 minutes. You can, if at all, if you want to report it as a factual situation, there should be a delay, right? So that is what which was ruled out in this particular case of Star Sports versus a few telecom companies, right? So this is where how a small cricket data, sir, and the technology to transfer those things have all been how it has been managed. And that is the reason where IPR plays a role. And here the issue of how a right to information and the consumer, the rights of the Star Sports and rights of the consumer and rights of the press plays a very important role. Right, these are the issues which is also there. Your artistic work, dramatic work, musical work, cinematography and sound recording. Cinematography is a huge issue which was there few years before, where you can today morning the movies are being released on Friday, tomorrow the movies are released tomorrow and on the Friday morning afternoon you will be able to see those movies in the various websites, and it was uploaded. If that happens, what about the creator? The creator who have spent hundreds of crores over coming out with a particular movie and today morning the movie is released and someone goes and shoots the movie in the theater and puts it in the internet and thousands of people having viewed or lakhs together of people downloaded. What is the effect of the creator? This was a huge issue which came. Court gave various kinds of orders such as anti-pillar order, injunctions and Ashok, Mareva injunctions, various injunctions were all given to stop these pirated websites. But it was a huge issue 2-3 years before. Today, you cannot find, and there is this, and earlier the internet service provider said that, sir, under the Information Technology Act, I am exempted because, sir, this is a pipeline which goes, the contents are going, and there is thousands of lakhs together, crores together of contents which is going and I don't have any connection, like your internet service provider, like various people. And I don't have any connection. If it goes, then what should I do? And the court said earlier they had an exception under the Information Technology Act. But later court said that no, it is your pipeline. You know what is going in your content. Then you should curb those pirated products, pirated websites. You cannot simply say that, oh, I don't know, right? This was a challenge and a technological development or various technological measures were taken to stop this particular piracy. And today you don't find lot of websites which they can host your pirated movie or Pirate Bay, Tamil Rockers, or there are various such websites which was there and today it is all been blocked. Okay, yes. Yeah, so copyright and trademark. Yes, trademark is in the name, word, sound, number, color, fragrance mark, taste mark. A trademark is valid for 10 years. Every 10 years, you can keep on renewing. Copyright is valid for 10-year lifetime of an author plus 60 years. So these are the examples of trademark. So patent, see here, you can also see the technology used for, the persons for each and every movement, how it was how he's been playing and identifying the problem in it and coming out with the further improvement. And for this technology, a patent can be granted. And as I said, the three major requirements for patent, which is novelty, non-obviousness, industrial application. Patent is valid for 20 years. It creates an exclusive right to you for making, using, selling, offering for sale, and importing your invention. So, see, the invention is not only in the match. The 3D scanner today, the thermal scanner for identifying a person's temperature is also a technology which is patented. Forget about that. What about these shoes? Is also patented one. Okay, there are certain inventions which is not patentable, such as you can pick the call, such as invention which is contrary to the public order and morality. A mere admixture is not patentable. Invention obtaining a traditional knowledge is not patentable. Presentation of abstract idea is not patentable. Mathematical or business model per se is not patentable. Your computer program is also not patentable, provided if you your computer programming having a novel hardware, then only it is patentable. Your anything related to atomic energy, arms and ammunition, no patents in India. So designs is a very important one. Design is in the shape, pattern, arrangements or color combination or an ornamentation applied to an article and which is aesthetically appealing to an eye. Design is protected for 15 years, extendable for 5 years, 15 years maximum. So the design, the essential requirement for design is that it should be eye-catchy feature. It should be new or original applied to an article. It should not be a functional feature because functional feature is protected under the patents. If it is an artistic work like painting, sculpture, it is protected under copyright, not under designs. Yeah, so very important slides and having my questions posed. Okay, now you saw this, right? Now tell me,
so there's a formal. To close, no? Then we can.
Madam?
So you have 12 minutes to close.
Yeah. This is in one or two slides. I'll be finishing it. So now this is a question from my side. There is a formula. There is a chemical formulation for some kind of a problem of eye. If you come out with this, what kind of protection will you like to get it? Some answers in the chat box, please. What protection for your formula, new formula for an eye problem if you have come out with? What is the protection would you like to take for? Under the IPR.
Proposition.
No. Next.
Sir, drug design. Atul Bhargava says drug. Aurora sir says design.
No, not design. Not that. Design you will choose for next one. Next.
Next.
Design what protection?
By Srinivasan. Satya Swarupa copyright. Kalyani. Chemical formula.
You should not go for copyright.
Chemical formula by Kalyani.
What does he say?
Formulation.
What protection for the formulation you will go for?
Dr. Praveena combination, Arundhati patent for formula.
Correct. Patent. Yes. Wait. Arundhati madam, you are right. You take a protection under the patent for the chemical formula which you have come out with. Okay, now what is this? Something which is there on the product. What protection will you go for?
Design, I believe.
No, madam. Something on the product.
Something on the product logo.
Yeah, excellent. Correct. So that is a trademark you go for. Yes, it is correct. Now tell me, what about the bottle? What production will you go for this?
Trademark. They are saying Aurora.
Shape of a bottle, madam.
Design. Aurora sir says
correct.
Design.
Yes, Aurora. Correct. So you take a design protection. Come on, tell me, what about this?
Technology.
Be careful in answering. What protection will you take for this?
Technology.
Yes. So what protection?
Design.
No.
Shape.
No. It is not just a shape.
Surabhi says
process. Yes, process. Process.
So process means what? Which production?
Process of
innovative.
Of course, it is innovative. What protection you will go for?
Cover, usage.
Okay. IPR.
Of course, IPR. In IPR, which sir?
Patent, sir.
Excellent. Madam, you go for patent. Sir, identify here. What is this? See, as soon as some kind of a project product goes to near your eyes, there is a natural tendency of the eyes to close. So a person identified, the inventor identified, yes, there's a particular problem. He came out with a solution, a small stand. Sir, this does not have science. This does not have a great technology, no chemical formulation. What it had a innovative thought in it. Solving a problem during the administration of medicine to an eye. So this is what he came up with, and he filed a patent. You can get a patent for this, because this is not a design, because this is a functional feature. One of the sir was telling, sir, it is a process. Yeah, for a process, you apply for a patent. Okay. Yes. So for your user guide, you go for copyright. Some of the supplies, you go for trade secrets protection. Okay, yes, a single mobile phone, sir, has thousands of patents in it. A laptop has thousands of patents in it. A single mark on the product, such as Apple, Samsung, is a name of a product, is a trademark protection. The shape of a mobile phone is design protectable subject matter. Your songs, your software, your computer program, or images are all copyright protected. IP, for the explaining an IP, a single mobile phone is more than enough. So with all these things, what we wanted to say you is that the IP is very important. You are all innovative. So here I say, be innovative. Sorry, you are all innovative. You're all innovative. You come up with various solution for a problem. So for such solution of a problem, for such innovations, protect under the IPR. Think out of the box. Don't buy the fakes. Produce original work. Only then we prosper. That is where the Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi, during the National Science Congress, he made a statement and he gave a specific slogan to all of us that innovate, patent, produce, and prosper. So we need to know this I3P. I refer for innovation. 3 P's refer for 1 P for patent, 2nd P for production, and 3rd P for prosperity. You innovate, you get a patent, you produce in India and supply it to for the people in India, and there is a prosperity. Why he said this particular statement in a single statement, I would like to clarify that today Apple phone comes with a so costly price because the technology is completely from outside, and you are paying not just for the royalty of the product or the for the material cost, rather you're paying for the intellectual property, the technology. That is where it is costly, right? So with that, if you produce in India, if you innovate in India, if you get a patent in India, then we are going to get prosper, not only you, but also in India as well. So with that, I would like to thank the organizer for providing me an opportunity to interact with in this particular faculty development program. And it was a great honor for me. And it was really surprising that all the participants have actively jumped in and answering, in the chat box. And also, in spite of my request, people were opening up their mic and answering. I know your curiosity. I know your enthusiasm. I really salute for that. We from Karnataka State Council for Science and Technology at Indian Institute of Science support innovators and inventors in protection, promotion, and commercialization of your intellectual property rights. And that's all from my side. And thank you very much. Jai Hind. Madam, over to you.
Thank you so much, sir. I think I was just listening, and initially when it started, I was wondering, like, it's all about cricket, because I am a person who don't understand ABCD of cricket. And then it was like the responses were pouring in, and then you beautifully connected that concept of cricket to technology, and then you said innovation, then you explained us in a very connected manner, like, okay, this is how it is. And towards end, the examples were really mind-blowing, like you said. What are the layers where, that one last slide where you are talking was giving us a breakup, and whole lot of information we could understand through that one slide. Thanks for that great effort you made, sir. And thank you for being here in the session. And on behalf of Acharya Bangur B School and AICT Atul, we thank Vivekanand Sagar sir as well as IISE Nagarjun sir for referring your name, as well as our Dr. Sengattuvel sir, who initially got in touch and corresponded with Nagarjun sir to have you here in the session, sir. So thank you for joining us, sir. With this, I open for QA. Please share contact details once again, sir. If you could put your name and details in the chat box now, because you have stopped sharing, it would be great, sir. People can reach you. Would it be okay to share your PPT later so that we make it available to the participants? So last slide can have your contact details, Twitter, LinkedIn, or any email ID details which you would like to share. So that will come in the PPT. Yeah, sir has already put his email ID. Fine. Okay. Yeah, with this, we are now open to the question. Anybody wants to ask question? Sengattuvel sir is thanking, sir. Sengattuvel sir, if you are there on the session, please unmute and speak, sir, so that at least Vivek sir, you can connect here once.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir. Professor Sengattuvel. Actually, this was thought to connect with Karnataka State Council for Science and Technology during June and July itself. But due to this COVID-19 pandemic, we could not, you know, associate. We are happy, very happy to associate with the Karnataka State Council for Science and Technology in future programs also. Your session was very insightful and informative session. Thank you so much for accepting our invitation and doing the honor. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. The pleasure is mine.
So with this, we open the session for questions.
So my name is Kalyani. Thank you, Jeevaratna ma'am. My name is Kalyani, and it was a great honor listening to you. I don't think there is any patent on fastest finger first, I guess. You need to clarify that. And then whose sound travels faster, whether it is fastest finger first or the sound, the way Jeevaratna ma'am and her coordinates were trying to read out the answers for you. I think this was...
I really appreciate
Isn't it? You made it challenging for us to listen. All the time we were listening through all the sessions, but here we had to play, we had to contribute, and no way I had any technical glitches but for you. So you are a real challenge, because my phone went down again. I had to fall back on the PC and all that, but it was great listening to you. So good, nice. It was really on high, and the kind of the energy levels you produced, you know, it was an inspiration for us to match up to that as well. Thanks for that. And coming to the question I had yesterday, I was going through an article, because this is a technology management session. Just wanted to ask you. Now, there's this mother in Australia who gave her phone. It is an iPhone, Apple phone, to her son who is 6 years old. The son is George. And this Apple phone had in-house app purchases. The child, in its innocence, kept on pressing the button the mother didn't knew. And all of a sudden, after some days, she came to know that her bank account got debited for about 11 lakh rupees. And when she raised it with the Apple company for a refund, it is very plainly denied it, because... How do we tackle
Madam, sorry, I could not.
Do I repeat the question again, sir?
Yeah. No, last portion.
Last part of the question, ma'am. Last part. How do I, till that we were audible.
Okay, the mother wanted the refund, and the Apple has clearly denied it cannot give the refund, because it failed to meet the criteria of 60 days.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, this is one very interesting thing. And in India also, we had a similar case. There was this student who cleared Tripoli, and he clicked wrongly the refund link, and his admission got cancelled. Now the SES ruled and the admission got, he got back the admission. But you know, such kind of things which are very dangerous and alarming, at the click of a button, everything happens. And how safe is it, and how will the law protect this?
Yeah. I will just take 2 points. Okay. Of course, as in my opening remark, I said technology is a bane as well as a boon. It has two faces of a same coin. One side it is a beneficial, another side it has a danger. As you said, in the Apple case of a mother who lost money out of here, these are all the cyber crimes or cyber issues, okay, which might have been, and if there was a fraudulently someone has taken, or it's a mistake of a child, okay, then it's a consumer and a supplier problem. So it's a consumer issue. So whether there is a whatever warranty, guarantee and protection they promise from the Apple side, they should have appropriately, dealt with it. So these are all the dealing with respect to a technology, how it misses the whole amount of money. Forget about this issue of losing money. Money, even in India today, lakhs together of money has been, in one of the case which I wanted to bring in was a banker. He just took 10 paise. A banker took just 10 paise from the customers or the bank customers account, only 10 paise. Would you mind if 10 paise is being lost from your bank account?
No, not really. I wouldn't want even a single paise to go away without my permission.
No, that is a different issue. You don't want a single rupee to go out of your account. But if a 10 paise is lost in the process of the whole thing, would you be looking at your bank statement stating that, hey, 10 paise has lost? And you must have seen in your bank statement, there would be so much of charges like ATM charges, etc. Once in a year, in the month of April or March, there will be some of the thing which you don't have any say in it. Neither you get a message. Only if you take a statement for your income tax, you will come to know what are the charges being deducted from the bank. So this particular banker just deducted 10 paise from thousands of lakhs together of people, of consumers, and he was not even caught at the initial stage. Only at a later stage, this lakhs together of money, lakhs together of consumers, 10 paise contributed to crores together of money for this particular fraud. So likewise, a small, in a single click, he took 10 paise from all the consumers. So these are the opportunities which is there in technology, which is dangerous for us. So we should be very careful in it in such circumstances. And recently, one of the important situation that one of the actor who made a damaging statement of a star in Karnataka by some person, and later on people hacked his mobile phone and various videos, etc., were being exposed. And must have also seen one of them, whether I don't know, in the cyber crime or cyber security class, whether a particular person told about this particular example where a student, her pictures were taken in the mobile phones, were being leaked out and taken by someone else, and they misused it, and how cyber forensic or cyber crime police station, which is there, took an action against it. So there are various such incidents, and technology is really dangerous. Most of them, in one of the experts in the technology, experts in the cyber law, most of them say having a Google account, having a phone pay, Google Pay, is itself dangerous. They don't have Google Pay or phone pay in their account. They does not even have a credit card. They say, better, I will go and withdraw from the bank and I will be happy. I'm happy to draw from the bank and transfer it through the traditional mode, and let me not venture into the technology. That is also there as in one apprehension. Today, I just wanted to say one more case law. However, with the have a time. This was a case of a cyber craze where a father, mother and 5 children were there. They went for a, they goes for a family tour to some country. After some days, the child, you must have known your children or your friends, they would have put that, hey, come on, I am in the airport. Today we are going to Singapore. And in the Singapore, you take a picture and say, this is a statue of, or the towers or whatever. Some of the pictures you would have posted, right, in your Facebook. After all these things, the That's our last child post, put up all these photos in their Facebook and they comes back to the home. Now, when they come back to the home, what do you find in the home? What do you find in the home? Can anyone give an example answer? What do you find in your home? What was there in your home? Chat answers, please. What do you find? I can read the chat answer. Nothing. Theft. Very, very, very good, Mr. Guru. Sendu Kumar. Nothing. Stolen. Everything is gone. Your house is cleaned and washed away. That means what? Your house is cleaned and washed away, and somehow the father of the home, he gets the sacred CCTV camera which he has placed. He sees that particular CCTV camera. It reveals, as soon as these people go out of the home for a family tour, the next day morning there is a robber, a thief comes to the home, a single person. For 20 days he enjoys in the home. He drinks there, he eats there, he orders pizza. He opens up the TV, he arms a view the TV, television, sleeps there. Everything he does. And before these people arrive, one day early, he packs the whole house and he leaves the house. Everything has been recorded. How it was possible? Because of the Facebook of a child. The child which was posing that, hey, in next 20 days, we are going to Singapore. And on the day she puts a picture that I'm in the airport. Today we are boarding the airport. We are so happy. My father, my sisters, brothers, we are all together. Every pictures has been uploaded. And one fine day you say, hey, come on, today we are all finishing and we are coming back. Happy to be back to India, our motherland, etc. and etc. You come in the motherland, everything is gone away. This is a situation happening because of the technology. This is a situation. Today, you don't know one more situation. I think this is an example many of them would have quoted.
That differ from your point, sir, because technology offers us benefits because I am a tech person. One should always be aware about the privacy and the security concerns when technology is given to you.
So absolutely, absolutely.
I do that. I don't know. I request most of you to do that. You know, when I go for private conversations, because I get in touch with a lot of celebrities and other people where I have to do a confidential discussion, the first thing I'm going to do is switch off my phone and request the other person also to switch off the phone. And most of the times you don't believe, even now I sit with a notebook, pen, paper, that is still the best method.
Absolutely.
I'm sure I bring that paper. Because you know, as an advocate, the type of confidential discussions what we get into, it would never be safe to sit with a phone.
Never.
The handbag of the celebrity is also outside.
Yes,
so we just absolutely. We get into the boardrooms, we get into the discussion, and that will be a designated boardroom. We don't go to other boardrooms. I think as an advocate, you know what I'm trying to tell. Because the technology... Yes. Today is no secure until and unless
so much intervened. Control it is so off. Much intervened. Yes.
And
yes.
Most of us are not aware, and because of that, all this situations occur.
Yes. If some of
that, I had to defer for the point.
Yeah. No problem. If any of them would have observed during the parliamentary debate in US, okay, where one of the member of the Senate ask a question, cross examine Sundar Pichai, who was the CEO of the Google, that, hey, come on, I have a mobile phone today with me here. If I move from here to some other seat, will the Google be able to identify my movements? He said, I'll just restrict my talk to the technology. That means technology is following everywhere. It knows what you are going to order. It knows what is your favorite dish. It knows what is your health condition. What is your age? What are you going to order? What are your initial 2-3 words is more than enough to recognize. The algorithm will recognize, the system will recognize everything about you. You know, there was also one more situation that there was one notification comes to the father, says that your daughter is pregnant. Okay,
we had a speaker sharing about this in one of our sessions,
we had
a session and Amazon.
Amazon sends the information to the message to the father stating that your daughter is pregnant. What do you mean by that? because the daughter ordered for few goods which is related to the pregnancy, and the message goes to the father that she is pregnant, and that is how the technology is so fast. And there was also in one of the famous show in US, she says Amazon will come up with the next thing that today, if you want to think something, hey, tomorrow, today I just want my Aadhaar card, which is I have lost. Okay, it knows and sends me Aadhaar. Okay, so it sends a request to the Aadhaar that you have lost the card, hence I need to have. Today it sends everything. So this can be a situation tomorrow. Okay, so
I agree with all the points what you're saying, and we have to be, you know, very careful when it comes to technology.
Absolutely.
So since we are running, you know, out of time, we're already 2 minutes. Thank you so much. Like you made it simple, as I already mentioned in the thank you note. And I think participants also have a lot of appreciative comments for you on the chat box, because now you can read the chat box. You are able to access that.
Yeah, I just saw. I scrolled everything.
You covered everything.
And that is my reward. No, that is my reward, and that's where I feel really happy. But I don't feel happy if you say thank you very much, sir, and other things. But I'm only happy when you come out with one invention and one copyright, which gives you a blockbuster returns. And you say, sir, because of that particular insightful session, today I'm able to have a patent. Today I'm able to have a copyright. And this is what I'm earning. If you say, then I'm happy. So with that note, I request everyone to be very careful in understanding the process and product which you come out with, file or get patents or IPR protection for it, so that you can effectively have a protection over your intellectual property, and you are not duped out of it, and you are being effectively protected. No one copies your work without your permission.
Question which I wanted to highlight, because that is something related to technology, before we close. I think Atul Bhargava asked that question, if I read it right, like can the algorithms be patented?
No, that's fair. See, algorithms, you should not say in a patent document. See, Intel.
I remember you the way he described the wicket.
Absolutely. You rightly pointed out. See, you should not say mine is an algorithm or a business model, then you are gone. But if you say it's a system, see, a patent is granted for two things. One, for a process or for a product. So you should say it is a process, a system of identification of a movement from one orientation to another orientation. There is no wicket, there is no LED, there is no sensor, nothing. Right. Yes. That is how you file a patent application. It itself, a patent application is a techno-legal document. It is not only technology, it is a techno-legal document. So there is it is an art. A filing an application for patent is an art itself. So you should be very careful in filing an application. Approach professionals to get it appropriately protected. And if at all, if you require any assistance, we at Karnataka State Council for Science and Technology are at KSC, at Indian Institute of Science, to support you on any aspect which you require. Yes, madam.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. That was really welcoming. And thanks for the session. And thank you all participants.